guys, I am Chris Kaler.
And I'm Amber Fossen-Kudin, and today we are back at guys with Vinland Saga, episode 9.
Last episode, Askeladd's group went home for winter, and Thorfinn had his duel. It was actually pretty good. He managed to put Askeladd on the defense.
But Askeladd used dirty tricks like insulting, I don't recall your father. Yeah. He was nothing.
It was very effective. Björn was saying that Thorfinn got better, but then he was disappointed by how he is a slave to his emotions, unfortunately, and it showed. He let himself get angry, and that's when he made mistakes, got his shoulder dislocated for the trouble. Askeladd said something about how we're all slaves to something, and how you basically handle those slaves, how you manipulate them, that can basically come back and help you in the end. So it's confirmation that he sees Thorfinn as a slave and he's been using him, which it shows, but Thorfinn doesn't see it. He says he's not a slave, he's a warrior, he does what he wants, but do you?
He's a slave in everything that matters except the title, basically.
Yeah, so he met a slave girl too, but I don't know if we're gonna see her again. It looks like at the end of the episode, we jump all the way to spring already, or maybe it was right before, I don't know, but still, the fight is happening. We met the guy with the helmet, he's Knut. The same Knut maybe from Valhalla? I don't know. He needs to prove that he's worthy of the throne, because he's a contender, and so he's going to go on a battlefield and prove himself, even though he has no fight experience, apparently. They are currently, at the end of the last episode, they were attacking the London Bridge. I can't speak today. They were attacking the London Bridge, and we saw, I confirmed it, it's the same guy who was with Thor's at the very beginning on the boats. So, okay. Thor's friend from back in the day when he was in the Jomsviking army. So, he's there, he's having the time of his life, and he's enjoying the battle.
Alright.
I do wonder if we get to meet him. That would be really cool. Mm-hmm. I don't know how that would go, but that would be interesting to learn about our father. We'll see. So let's jump in this episode and see what we do next. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more of these and check out our Patreon for the full-length reactions.
All right, guys, let's go!
Flashbacks from Vikings Valhalla.
The bridge is falling down.
Again, like, the different shows we've seen talk about similar events constantly, but it's always so different. We don't know which one is true.
Yeah.
It's never an easy win. With the enemy, Torkel being the friend we saw. Oh, they hired Vikings.
Yeah.
Make a name for yourself, basically.
For everyone's goal, this is the place to be. I wanted to meet our dad's friend, but not like this. He's a bit tired of doing stuff for him. Yeah, don't piss him off more, man. Maybe one day. As long as you do not let go of that anger, I don't think it's gonna happen. But like, first of all, he seems to be a better opponent than everyone else we've seen so far.
Torkel?
I mean, compared to the guy he got, the general from Francia and all of that. Second of all, he knew our father. We don't look like our father, but what if, like...
Oh, we might have the same look in our eyes, though. You know?
I don't want him to kill him. I'd rather we speak. We'll see what happens. With the Gaia actually one dead.
Who knows? It might follow us because of a father legacy's sake.
That depends if he knows, if he recognizes him or something. I don't even know if he's ever seen him. Probably not.
We're here to talk.
What? You don't give a shit.
God damn.
He's huge.
He really seems to just enjoy his job.
Okay.
Yeah, last time you offered a deal like this, you planned for the death of the guy you brought back.
Yeah.
He goes where the money is.
What?
Right there.
They don't understand. What is he saying? So it's literally the same battle. Prince Edmund.
To have a wordy opponent for once.
If he goes to the other side, it's just gonna be a massacre. At least like this, he has a challenge. He enjoys this.
Oh shit.
Oh my god. Oh shit.
That's your answer?
He's crazy, man. This is the attitude I would have expected of a Floki. Thanks to Viking.
Oh no, they escape.
That's literally why he's fighting in the English. He wants a challenge. But like, Thorfinn is gonna try to kill this guy. How? He's a beast. We're gonna see a blonde flash just...
No, you mean...
jump like his dad. They're not as subtle as Leif Erikson. You want a new mask for your boat? How many are there to hold one when he can just throw it himself?
Just look at him just jumping on the bridge.
Hello! The son of someone you knew? Jump, Thorfinn! It literally jumped!
But I mean, he can't defy gravity, so...
Will you recognize the jump? It's so smooth. The advantage against a big guy like this is we're faster. We're swift, we're a smaller target.
But he's more experienced.
Yep. Yeah, he never saw him, he doesn't know who we are, and we don't look like our father.
His friend, Thor's, left before he was born, so yeah.
And would it make a difference? He's twice his size! Don't underestimate him.
You're basically fighting a mountain!
Be quicker. God damn. I like how everyone is surprised whenever he shows some skills.
Well, they don't expect that from a kid.
Yeah.
Attack his legs!
Put him down, make him kneel. And then after that, yeah. Yes, the knee. If you make a giant fall, this is best.
Whoa, that look, that look.
Oh. It's his father's knife. Maybe he'll recognize that.
God damn.
Recognize the knife, please. You knew, you don't give a shit.
You're just gonna leave him there?
Yeah, he doesn't give a shit.
Oh.
If he doesn't have a purpose anymore, if he's not useful.
No.
Oh!
The fingers again!
It's always the fingers. He's not gonna give up, he has a purpose.
Thorfinn Thorson? Son of
Thor's.
Yeah.
Fuck. It's okay. He knows now.
Hey!
Let him go.
I actually like the respect he's showing him just by saying that. And like, they are enemies, I don't think that's gonna change, but by being Thor's son, there's maybe he's seeing like, oh, that would be interesting to see what you're made of as a warrior.
Or is that interesting as a kid warrior, so yeah.
But that stumps and shit.
Like this?
Bring down the bridge. It is the city though.
このイングランド全土の掌握を優先せねばならん。本体を西へ移動させる。ロンドン包囲は続けさせよ。4000の士気は。Canute?
So he can prove himself? We'll see what he's made of. In Vikings Valhalla, he's the one that takes London.
話が違うではありませんか? 民に示しをつけるためと、慣れぬ戦場で信頼も重ねられて、責任でもあるのだぞ。 キリストの教えのせいか、妙に器用に育ってしまった。甘やかすからだ。包囲軍の将を任ずる副将として補佐せよ。I
kind of want him to succeed just to prove them that he can do it.
But I mean, he doesn't have any battlefield experience, but he can still be a good strategist.
Sometimes it doesn't mean shit. And they're saying he's like weak in a way, but like, we don't know. Yeah. We could be surprised. If he's half as good as Canute in Vikings Valhalla, it'll be great. He was beat up pretty bad, so...
And we lost a dagger.
And like he fucking flung him around, like maybe that shoulder's dislocated too. Again. We did lose a knife.
Hang in there.
We won? They're coming back.
He might have won the first battle, but he might not won the war.
Thor girl's like, oh shit! No, shut up! Everyone's like, yay, finally! Come back! He'll take the whole army by himself. He has a goal, he's not gonna die. You said to bring Thorkell's head. You're not gonna leave him behind, I guess. You would be feeling weak as shit if a guy can, you know, swing you around like that. Maybe like he made fun of you by saying like, it's fun, let's go. Kid, I love you, you need help. Okay, I feel like the thing that got out the most in this episode was reasons for fighting. From Thorfinn to Askeladd to Björn to Thorkell, which a lot of Thors in this show, man. So Björn and Askeladd being the two first that spoke about this, Askeladd is doing it for the money. We know his uncle is obsessed with money, and I guess in a way, Askeladd, that's his reason for fighting. I think he enjoys a good fight, but he goes where the money is, he goes where the prize is. If there's a reason, he's gonna do it.
If there's no gain in it,
there's no point. Yeah, why is he attracted to money like this? I can guess, like, maybe he wants to look out for his people. I felt like last episode, he was happy to offer his crew the meat that they wanted, the beer, the ale that they wanted. Like, he's just happy to... He wants to enjoy life. He wants to enjoy life, maybe. Mm-hmm. And the best way to do that is with money. So maybe this is why money is his main focus. Björn doesn't give a shit about money. He enjoys the fight. So he enjoys killing. Not the fight. He enjoys killing people. So for him, it feels
he's
more like...
He's a psychopath. Okay. Fine.
Yeah. But for him, it feels like maybe it's... asserting his strength. So by proving himself that he's the best, proving himself that he's the strongest, and that he gets to keep living, keeps, you know, surviving, and the others get to die, maybe it gives him that feeling that he lives on, and it makes him feel more alive, perhaps? But we can only guess. Like, he just said he enjoys killing. And then you have Thorfinn and Thorkell seems to just enjoy a good fight. He likes a challenge.
He wants a challenge. And the more difficult it is, the more pleasure he finds in it.
Well, I think it's just a play of skills. Like, he knows he's good, and he doesn't want it to be easy. He doesn't... For him, it's not just killing. So kind of like Björn would be okay with fighting a losing army, because that he gets to kill people, he gets to assert his strength and push them down. Like, no one gets to rise above him. He pushes them back down. For Thorkell, it's more than that. So fighting a losing army would not be enough, because he doesn't enjoy defeating the others. He enjoys the challenge of the fight. So someone like Thorfinn, who is driven by his motivation, driven by his you know, his goal in life,
yeah,
and he gives him a challenge because he's never going to give up, he would find that very nice, very enjoyable. He'd be saying, hey, we had fun. This is surprising that a kid like you would go against me.
Come back! Come back!
And he chose to fight for the English because he fought the English before and he realized they were fucking weak.
Yeah,
so
compares to his previous team, I mean, why not change?
But that's the thing. He doesn't enjoy... I don't think he enjoys, from what he said, I don't think he enjoys killing his enemy or even winning against his enemy. I think he'd be totally okay with losing a battle if it meant that was the fight of his life. Hmm. He's not afraid of that.
I can understand for a warrior... Warrior, thank you very much. Why there will be no satisfaction to fight someone that is maybe so weak compared to your own strength.
It depends on what you expect from this. Some, like Thorfinn was saying at the end, like, what's fun about battles? Like, he doesn't understand Thorkell, because he does it not because he enjoys fighting, not because he enjoys killing. He does it because that's the only way he thinks he can get his duel against Askeladd. So it goes against what he was as a kid, what he was thought, what he feels inside. We don't really know what
he saw. I think of now, Thorfinn finds that battle and just fighting is a burden for him, because that's his only way to have a way to his goal, which is killing Askeladd.
We already know he feels bad about killing others. Like, we said it before, like, he doesn't have a grudge against these people. The only one he truly wants to kill is Askeladd. But to get that, he needs to kill people he has no grudge against, no anger against, no relation to. So for him, it would be meaningless. But those deaths mean nothing to him, except it's breaking his spirit. It's turning him into a murderer. It's turning him into someone he doesn't like. But he feels like he has to do it to get to Askeladd. So meeting someone like Thorkell, who enjoys the fight, he's like, oh, let's do it again. It was fun. And he's having a blast just fighting people. He would be pissed, because, like, it's kind of like you're making fun of what he's doing, which is
struggle,
killing. You're basically talking lightly about the act of killing, the act of fighting. You toyed with him. I mean, he didn't lord over him, but he was so obviously strong, and he just had a blast fighting Thorfinn, even though Thorfinn, for him, it was so serious why he was doing it, and it meant something, it had a weight to it. So if for Thorfinn, the idea of killing someone hurts him so much, to see other people who were like, I don't give a shit, like, I'll do it because I enjoy it, it's fun, he'd be put out like, why do you find this attractive? Why do you find this funny? He cannot imagine feeling like this towards battle, because for him, it's a struggle constantly. But yeah, I feel like Thorkell's just, maybe he got so strong that he found no joy, like no challenge anymore. So now he goes wherever the challenge is. He'll put himself in situations where it's going to be tough to defeat anyone, tough to win.
Like I said, I understand why for a warrior, he would decide to make those decisions. It's like people who only fight with honor, and to do otherwise would be like a blow to their reputation, just to their spirit.
Like I said, it comes down to the reason why you fight.
When you're so strong like Thorkell, and you fight people who are just so weak in comparison, it's like you're fighting a baby. There's no pleasure in it, there's no satisfaction, there's no...
But again, like I said...
Not really honor, but there's no greatness doing it.
But again, like I said, compared to Bjorn, who I think would be fine with killing someone that's weak, because he likes to kill, he said...
Power play, but I being the one who is stronger to another person, enough to just take away their life.
He enjoys killing, that's what he said, literally. As for Thorkell, he enjoys the fight. So fighting someone who can't fight back, or someone who doesn't give him a challenge, that would not be fun. It comes down to the reason why they became warriors. Thorfinn became a warrior because he feels he needs to avenge his father. The reason behind it is sad, it's heartbreaking, it's destroying him little by little, he's being... destroyed by his feelings and his need for revenge. Thorkell, I have no idea why he became a warrior, but maybe he enjoyed, like, kind of like all those guys, like, even Thorfinn when he was a kid, they had this idea that fighting was great and honorable, and they wanted to become great warriors. Like, they idealized the idea of going to battle. Then Thorfinn was so young when he had a first taste of battle and death, maybe this tainted his tales and his stories of becoming a great warrior and going on adventures and killing people, going to war. It depends on how you get introduced to this world as well. If Thorkell, you know, got into the fight scene later on in life and it was not attached to any trauma, any grief, any death that was meaningful to him, he never had that basically his dream of being a great warrior was never tainted by dark emotions. So for Thorfinn, he connects fighting with death, loss, grief.
We don't know Thorkell's backstory, so we can just assume.
But this is what I'm getting from this episode. Thorkell, right now at the very least, connects fights with challenges, blast fights. Maybe, you know, he used to challenge friends back in the day. Like, if he was friends with Thor, used to say that he didn't fight with him here and there just to prove his strength and just to have a challenge. Maybe if he used to be with Thor, he never found a challenge like him ever again since he left, and he's looking for that drive and that adrenaline again. And there's that too. Kind of like when you go on a roller coaster, the reason why people go back to roller coasters is because when you have that fear, like, a part of why we enjoy roller coasters is because we have that fear of we might crash. It's crazy, but it's true. Like,
it's the adrenaline and the dopamine.
Yeah, like, that adrenaline would not be there if you had not a certain fear of something might go wrong, but you know that it's not going to go wrong, or at least you hope it's not going to go wrong. So that's why you get to enjoy it. You feel the scary shit, you feel the adrenaline, but you know that you're going to come home safe after. So you get to enjoy it. Well, it's a bit the same for Thorkell. He's so good at his job. He's strong, so he gets to enjoy the fight and the adrenaline.
You know he's going to go back home at the end?
Well, maybe not. But then again, he's a Viking. Vikings don't fear death necessarily. So if they get to die, like, fighting, this is what they love doing. They go to Valhalla. They're just going to reunite with all the other warriors. They fought. Like, he has no personal grudge with anyone. He has no grudge or, you know, no goal that drives him, except he just wants to live life to the fullest. It's not too different from what I said about Askeladd. It's just that the way Askeladd, I feel, enjoys life is different than how Thorkell enjoys it. But then again, I think Askeladd also enjoys a good challenge. I think he enjoyed his fight with Thors. It's just he doesn't get to meet people like that often. Whereas for Thorkell, like, he doesn't get to meet that often either. So he looks for those challenges. But yeah, Thorfinn would not understand that. He was too young when he was introduced to this world. He was too traumatized. And he connects this with the death of his father. So there's nothing enjoyable about this. He became this to avenge his dad. And he would not have become this if his dad was still alive. So everything that's related to this new reality of his is obviously going to be bad. It's going to be sad. It's going to be angry. It's just dark and ugly. So someone that just enjoys it and has fun doing it, he's going to feel insulted. He's going to feel played with, like made fun of. Kind of like you are disregarding the reasons why he's doing it. It means so much to him. And it does so much to him mentally.
Yeah.
To see someone just go through that and not give a shit, you'd be feeling like, are you making fun of me? Are you like just having like your blast and you don't give a shit what it's doing? Like you're basically disregarding my trauma.
Why is it that I'm struggling so much to just do this job and is have a heavy toll on myself and you're just here on that bridge and you're just having a blast with it?
Kind of like Askeladd just being like, you want to kill me? You want your duel? Then do stuff for me. And he doesn't really give a shit if he comes back or not. Like, he's useful. As long as he's useful, you can stick around. And he's saying like, if you can't keep up, I'm just leaving you behind. To him, it doesn't mean shit because he sees an opportunity to use Thorfinn. And I'm guessing maybe over time, like, we need to see more maybe Askeladd's side of this. There's definitely a relationship between them. It's dark, it's twisted, but it's there. And in his own way, maybe Askeladd values Thorfinn, but he uses him for sure. Like, no matter how he sees the guy and how...
He said so in the last episode.
He saw an opportunity to use him, and so it is a twisted, dark relationship. But he doesn't give a shit if, like, sending him after Thorkell, he knows he's gonna do it. But he doesn't, like, he's also very aware that Thorfinn might not come back, but he knows he's gonna do it because of his drive. But to use him like that, to manipulate him like that, and send him constantly on missions because, you wanna kill me, so I guess you're gonna do it, right? It's kind of like he's spitting on what it means to Thorfinn, this need to have the duel, the importance of his revenge. He's basically disregarding it by saying like, it matters to you, but it doesn't matter to me. So do my bidding, because I mean, you're a perfect candidate for those counting missions and for those killing missions. And then I'll give you your duel. But it's kind of like he doesn't see that Thorfinn could win eventually. At least that's the vibe he's sending to Thorfinn. So no wonder Thorfinn is getting pissed at Askeladd. And now he's like, I think he's no longer willing to just do missions without the promise of something.
Without saying that you're gonna fight me at the end, right?
Because before he thought he needed to, like he was told to prove himself on the battlefield, and Askeladd is still saying that. He's basically saying, yeah, you want your duel, the only way you get to have it is by going on the battlefield and doing something.
Mm-hmm.
So he's gonna keep trying, but now like he's in a hurry to get his duel again. He really wants to finish this.
Since it's so much in a hurry to finish that fight, to achieve his revenge, he's not gonna get it.
Well, he could. Like,
he
started well last episode.
He's not in the right mentality to achieve it.
As long as he doesn't really let go of that anger, or he doesn't let it... As long as he lets it control him, Askeladd can just use it against him whenever they fight. If he becomes dangerous for him...
If he let go of that anger,
hatred,
there won't be any need for him to... But there won't be necessarily a need for him to kill Askeladd.
I do think we might... I think we're going to kill Askeladd, for sure. I think it's going to happen. But whether or not he lets go of his anger... He might not let go of his anger, but he needs to grow above it a little bit. He needs to not let it control him. Because Askeladd can just fall back on that trick every time it gets too dangerous. And... I mean, to be fair, like, as long as he's allowing Askeladd to manipulate him like this, he will stay a slave doing the bidding. And, like, he's putting himself in danger. He's tainting, according to him, he's tainting his soul every time he kills someone. He's getting hurt so much. He's putting himself through hell. And he keeps pushing because he knows that he doesn't matter to Askeladd, and Askeladd would let him leave him behind if he was not useful anymore. Like he said, like, if you can't keep up, I'm leaving you behind. But he knows he needs to stick around to get his goal, so he'll have to push through the pain, push through the grief. But he's the only one doing that to himself.
Yeah.
Askeladd is not forcing him. He's saying, okay, this is what you want, so this is what I want in return. And Thorfinn is deciding to do it for his revenge. It all comes down to him, but he's not at a point in his life where he can just let that go. And I don't know if he'll ever get to that point. Not before we get to kill Askeladd.
You know, sometimes people say that, why am I so miserable? Why is life so difficult for me? Mm-hmm. And they don't realize that life is difficult for them because they are putting that burden on their shoulders.
Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes they're the only one that is capable of
making it better
for themselves, just like with Thorfinn right now.
Well, not always. Let's make the distinction.
Not always, but most of the time, your own difficulties in life depends on what you do with your own burdens. You know,
it depends on the difficulty. Like if you're like, for example, if you're struggling, you're doing four jobs, you're constantly working, and you cannot pay your bills.
Some
and stuff.
Of the burdens in life, you can just let go.
Yeah, there's a bit of it. Like, depends on the situation. But in Thorfinn's situation, he is the one choosing this life for himself because he could have gone home and he didn't, and he's choosing to stay with Askeladd. But then again, how much of that is truly on him when we know he was a kid that went through this trauma and now he is a slave to that anger? It's not easy to let go of that. But we'll see. Like, he needs to grow up. He needs to meet more people. Like, he doesn't understand people like Thorkell. He doesn't understand people like Askeladd, people like Björn. He doesn't understand them, but by being around them, learning more about them, he might change his mind a little bit about how he views life. I'm not saying he'll turn into these guys, but to understand that your way of thinking might not be the only way of thinking. Maybe this would open doors for him in the future, but we're not there. We're definitely going to meet Thorkell again. now he knows we're Thor's son. I think he believes it to be interesting. Like, there are so much he could tell him first. And on the fighting level, I think he would be interested in just, like, the kid is crazy, he's good. That was smooth as fuck, the fight. He's not giving up. And he's Thor's son, so we know he has a lot of potential. So as a guy who enjoys a challenge, maybe, like, if I'm right about him fighting Thor's back in the day and never finding that challenge again, so he's now seeking it, maybe he would see a possibility with Thor's kid. Like, hey, why not? Like, you can be a challenge.
Who knows?
So I think he would want to do round two with them, but I'm seeing it as an opportunity. Like, man, you could say stuff about his dad. He would maybe need this, right? But for that to happen, I kind of expected him maybe to stay behind in London and try again to get Thorkell's head. But it makes sense that if Askeladd would leave, follow the army,
he needs to be close to him.
Because if he loses Askeladd, who's to say he's gonna find them again?
Mm.
Speaking of which, that brings me to Canute. I really want him to show he can take London. I want him to prove himself. We don't know nothing about him. All I know is that he's probably the same Canute as in Vikings Valhalla, because they talked about Edmund, they talked about London, the bridge.
Yeah.
So it's the same
pretty much
situation.
The same timeline, more or less.
Yeah, so he's the same Canute, and if he's half as good as the Canute we know from Vikings Valhalla, he can pull it off. Like, he can do something great. But he has no battle experience, and Ragnar seems to be really afraid.
He's still a green bean, basically.
And they seem to be saying that is the fact that he's a Christian, the fact that he was raised a Christian, and he was raised that way, and he was pampered a little bit, like, it makes him weak. But we could be surprised.
Weak of heart. Not the same.
I mean, to me, it's sort of the same. Not weak physically, but he could show that he's willing. Like, we know he becomes King Canute, right? If they follow history like that, he's supposed to become King Canute at the very least. So I want him to prove himself, just because they keep talking shit, saying they don't trust, they don't believe he can do it much. Or at least they're like, yeah, I mean, he needs a wake-up call. He needs to prove himself and stuff. I'm like, yeah, okay. Please just follow through with that and show them. I'd like that. But we're going to follow the army. to keep fighting Wessex. So,
great.
Hopefully we get to see what happens in London, but if not, we'll learn about it later on. But yeah, we need to meet more people. We need to open doors for Thorfinn. Understand, you know, that there's more to life than revenge and battles and stuff. Like, I mean, we know that the ultimate way of thinking is that you have no enemy and a true warrior doesn't need a sword.
Yeah.
So we're not there. But in order to get there, you need to understand that this drive that you have is not the only thing that can push you forward. There's other ways to think about fighting. Mm. We'll see. He needs to grow up. But I love him so much and I want him out of that misery. It's not going to happen until like fucking later for sure.
Yeah.
But
probably the end of the first season.
Who knows? I don't know. I think season two might just... Apparently there's less fighting in season two,
okay. But
a lot more character development. So, the big stuff mentally might happen next season.
But I mean, we did say that if Thorfinn managed to kill Askeladd, what's next?
My theory is that killing Askeladd will not give him the satisfaction he expects. So he'll be lost.
The relief, yeah.
He might either be freaking lost, like he doesn't know what's next. Or, since he won't have the satisfaction, he'll turn his sight on someone else maybe. Until he realizes that it's never going to end if he keeps going that way. It's just never going to end. You're always going to want to find an enemy when, in fact, you decide that this guy is your enemy. If you let it go, you have no enemy. You'd be at peace.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be truly free. So he'll need to get there. Do the mental work.
Okay.
We say that every episode. He's not there yet.
He needs to grow.
Yeah. Okay, so that's it for this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching it with us. If you want to see the next two episodes right away, they are on Patreon already. You can check them out. The link is in the description below.
And if you don't want to have the next one, she'll be on YouTube pretty soon. So
yes.
We're going to see you then, guys.
Bye.
Bye.